I'm back with Masha Gessen talking about her book, Words Will Break Cement. In thinking about the Olympics and watching it from here, how are all that, well, you're watching it from here now too, right? How is it being seen or experienced from people you know there? Is it anticipation? Is it dread? Is it fear? Is it excitement?
I don't know anybody who's excited. I know people who are upset. Mm-hmm. I know people who've been investigating the corruption that has gone that has accompanied the Olympics, and there was actually a report out today,
which is about corruption about the building of the stadiums,
and right? All, yeah. And this report exposes just unbelievable amounts of corruption. Mm-hmm. Everything that was built over budget and over market price, and most of it by Putin's cronies. So that's one aspect of the Olympics. Mm. The other aspect of the Olympics that I think makes people worry and dread it a bit is it's basically they've created a sort of small military regime where the games are going to be. And among other things, for Russian citizens to go to the Olympic Games, they have to get a special passport, a special spectator's passport. Mm. People who are known to have participated in any protests, even as people who simply attended a protest, are not issued these passports. This is how afraid they are that any kind of protest that will take place during the games. But finally, what I fear most is what will happen after the games, because Putin has attempted to varnish his human rights image at least a little bit in anticipation of the games.
And that's connected to the Pussy Riot release, right?
That's connected to the Pussy Riot release. That's connected to the release of Mikhail Khodorkovsky, the former oil tycoon, and his business partner. And it's connected to the release of the Greenpeace activists who were kidnapped in September. But he will let loose after the games. I think we're going to see a lot of very repressive legislation, and I think we're going to see a lot of arrests and a lot of harsh sentences.
And does, when you, we were talking about the young people, how young these people are in Pussy Riot, are there other young people who are ready or willing to do more in this environment, or do they see all kinds of roadblocks that will prevent that?
Both. There are young women who are waiting for Pussy Riot to come out of prison, mm-hmm. and who I think will follow them to the ends of the earth. And that's an amazing phenomenon. We haven't seen a leader who inspires like that in a very, very long time in Russia.
Are the women aware of that leadership role?
Yes, I think they're aware. I think they're a little bit awed by it, mm-hmm. Because, again, they went in to prison unknowns, mm-hmm. and they came out worldwide celebrities. Mm-hmm. But at the same time, the crackdown has been designed to let people know that they don't even have to be leaders to go to jail. A lot of the arrests have been highly selective. They've arrested a lot of rank-and-file activists and people who have simply even just attended the protests, mm-hmm. exactly to communicate the message that you're risking everything even if you just come out into the streets.
And that is a detriment, certainly.
That's a huge chilling effect, yes.
Yeah. Masha Gessen, thanks so much.
Thank you.